Hey guys, Sean Tompkins here with a guitar tutorial. Today we're gonna do Sweet Jane. This is a Lou Reed song, Velvet Underground, redone by the Cowboy Junkies. And Cowboy Junkies is, they're both really similar songs, but a little bit different anyway. They're a little more acoustic style, and it's a really sparse, bare bones kind of style. I haven't seen any tutorials with the acoustic version as of yet, so I thought I'd do it, because this is where I play most of my music nowadays, is on acoustic. So anyway, let's get into it. This song is made up of three basic chords: D major, A major, and G major. So for the beginners out there, I'll take you through quickly how to play those chords, and then it's just kind of about the strumming and the timing when you're singing and the dynamics in the song. Because there are only a few chords, it really is about, you really want to concentrate on the dynamics. So we'll get into that. But anyway, the first part of the chords starts on a D. So open string, D. Second fret of your third string, your G string, is second fret there. And then third fret of the second string. Come in a little closer here so we can see. So open, D, and then third string, second fret, second string, third fret, and then second fret, first string. There's your D chord. Your A, second fret on your fourth, third, and second strings, and then you strum those five strings, starting on the A string. G is third fret, sixth string, second fret, fifth string, and then open, 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 all the way up to your B, and then your high E string is third fret. That's a G note. Bass G, high G. La la la, la la la, la la la, la la la, la la la. Okay? And that forms the basis of the verse and the chorus. Okay, you'll recognize that when you listen to the song and you start strumming along. That's those are the basics. So there are a couple parts here where we're going to hold on the D, and we're going to play sort of a bridge that goes into a couple of different chords here, which I'll take you through right now. The bridge though starts on D, so we already learned that one. And this part was heavenly wine and roses seem to whisper to me when you smile. So it's D, and then it goes to a C sharp major bar chord. You can play that in a couple different places. This is the closest one, so this is how I play it. And you basically just bar across the fourth fret, and then you bar with your index or your ring finger on the seventh fret, starting on the fourth, third, and second string. Okay, so this one bars across all five, and this one lays in there. You can kind of play it as a bar chord, like when Velvet Underground and Lou Reed play it, they kind of play everything in bar chords when they play this whole song. Right? But because we're playing on acoustic, you need a little bit more body. You don't have the amp to pump up the sound and whatnot. So you can play it a little bit more strummy and open. And so this big bar chord's just add a bit more layering to the notes, right? To the chord. So anyway, it's a D major, C sharp major for you beginners. That's going to be tough. But once you know your bar chords, that's nice because you can slide that around anywhere, right? The other place you can play C sharp major is up here. So that's a whole nother string in there too, but it's quite high and it's far from the rest of the chord, so you wouldn't typically play it there unless you had a real need for it. But we're gonna play it here. So D, C sharp major, and then we go back to our G chord, and then to our A chord. And there's a little bit of a difference in the strumming It's a little bit more arpeggiated, which is just a Italian, fancy Italian way of saying that you play each note of the chord kind of individually. So,
if only wine and roses seem to whisper to me when you smile.
So I kind of feather through. You do a rake. So you start on the D, it's, you arpeggiate on the way up out of the chord. So this is more of a picking technique. The fretting hand stays the same, and you strum down. It's kind of a half strum, a quick strum. So you rake down, and then it's still all the same notes in the chord, but it's sort of playing like this. You just play each individual note on the way up, and then you change chords. Chord twice.
You smile
again.
Heavenly wine and roses seem to whisper to me when you smile.
And then we kind of go into a pre-chorus back into the last chorus, which is a D major, which we've already learned, A, and then there is a C, and this is the la 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 part. And C is simply starting from the low notes first. You play the fifth string, third fret, and then second fret, fourth string, open G, and then second string, first fret. That's kind of, you're kind of doing that rake strum as well. It's not just a full
la 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 la.
We're sort of doing that
la 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 la.
The strumming kind of makes the song a little bit more interesting, because the whole rest of the song is just the D over and over. So if that's all you did the whole time, it would get a little bit repetitive, monotonous. So this is how you change it up. I guess the only other thing is, for that main part of the verse and the chorus, we're going to do... the song is really composed of the guitar, the singing, obviously, and then there's a drum portion that's it's pretty integral to the song, but it's sparse and it's really simple. So when I play it on acoustic, I like to add that bit of rhythmic strumming to it, just to add that extra something to your playing. So we kind of do one of these, and I kind of add in the muted strum just to give it a bit of a percussive sound. So it's a relatively slow song. So slow. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm kind of doing a strum with my hands and my pick at the same time. So I've got a pick here, and you can see my hand flick when I do it really slowly. And when we do that percussive strum, all I'm doing there is using the butt of my palm and flicking with my fingers while touching here. So if I didn't have my butt of my palm on the strings when I did that, it would sound like this. But so I'm kind of hitting the strings with my fleshy part of my hand and the top part of my nails at the same time. It kind of gives it a bit of a snare sound, as opposed to if you just did your fingers with it muted, doesn't quite have the same sound to it, does it? And if you did it without, it's just way too ringy and loose. So you kind of, it's kind of a motion you have to practice all in one. So open, chop. Da, 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 ch, da, 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 ch, da, 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 da. Slowly. One, two, three, four. Pretty much it, guys. If you can learn that, if you can learn those parts, and you can play the whole song. So as usual, I'll do a cover at the end, that way you can practice along with the whole thing and have fun with it. Let me know what you think in the comments. Here we go. Sweet Jane by the Cowboy Junkies and Lou Reed, or Lou Reed and the Cowboy Junkies. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Anyone who's ever had a heart wouldn't turn around and break it. Anyone who's ever played a part wouldn't turn around and hate it. Sweet Jane, Sweet Jane. Jimmy down in the alley, you're waiting for him to come back home. Waiting down on the corner, thinking of ways to get back home. Sweet Jane, Sweet Jane. Sweet.